हेलो, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रेंडर द स्किन एंड द हेयर. सो लेट्स नो अबाउट द कलर विच आई एम गोइंग टू यूज़. सो दिस टाइम आई हैव यूज रॉ सियाना एंड क्रिम्सन फॉर द स्किन टोन, एंड द पोर्शन वुड बी टू पोर्शंस ऑफ येलो, वन पोर्शन ऑफ रेड. सो यू विल गेट समथिंग लाइक दिस. सो दिस इज द कलर विच वी आर गोइंग टू यूज़ फॉर द स्किन. And don't forget to make it very watery. Add a lot of water to it because this is going to be the just first tone for the skin. For the hair, I'm using black and dark brown combination of both to do the hair, eyebrows, and eyes. Maybe I'll use a little bit of green for the eyes. Bit of green for the eyes, and I'm going to use this brownish red color for the second tone and third tone of the skin, and some pink for the cheeks. So let's get started. So this is the sketch. I have already done the body, and I showed you the process as well. So let's discuss the color which is going to be in every part. So it's a kalamkari dress, and as you know, kalamkari is beautiful hand painted fabric from Andhra Pradesh. So the style of Madhuban, style of kalamkari which we are doing here is floral with peacock prints. So this portion of the design is going to be in orange, this is going to be maroon, this is going to be orange. Dupatta is in white, and the whole body is going to be in blue, off-white, and likewise. So what we are going to do is, we are starting with the first layer of the color with watercolor. Always remember, whatever brand you choose to use for your watercolor sketches, for your illustration, always use for the base watercolor. Never start with a pencil color or a poster color, because poster color is very thick. It won't let pencil color to move over it. So start the base with a very watery finish of watercolor, and then you can use pencil color on top. So we'll start with the first layer of the colors. So the first color is the orange. So in the orange, the pure orange color which we have in the watercolor, I'm mixing vermilion red to it, very little. So two portions of orange, a touch of vermilion will give you this orange. The second color which we are using is maroon. Again, you have to take crimson, and in the crimson you have to mix bit of ivory black. So just a touch of ivory black and two portions of crimson red. And dupatta is going to be off-white, so just in white, just dip in any color and make it off. And so this is how your crimson color when mixed with black looks like, a bit of maroon. And then we have a blue color, which is again mixed with water, not sorry, white color. So take the lighter blue which you have in the palette, not very light, but a slightly light blue in your palette. Here I am using Kemlin blue. This is what it says on the tube. Mix it with a tinge of white, and this is what the color will, final color will look like. So let's get started with the first layer of the colors. So here we are done with the first layer of the color. Now we have to do the second and the third layer. So what I'm going to use, I'll start with this portion. And you have to use the darker orange you have in your color palette. And then you have to mix some red and some kind of brown to it. Brown, either brown or maroonish brown to it, to give it to the second and the third tone. So let's see how I am doing it. So just move the pencil around the orange which you have already colored to fill any gaps you see in the color, and don't press the pencil very hard to the paper. Just be very gentle. Just move around the pencil slowly. Don't press it against paper. Just do it slowly. So now you see all the extra area which was bit lighter, I kind of made it dark by moving the pencil. So what next we are going to do is that we'll go around areas which are beneath, you see the down portions. So this is going to be bit darker, all this area is going to be bit darker. So let's see how we can do it. So take some red and just move your pencil around this area. Very lightly, don't press hard against the paper, otherwise your paper will tear. So just do it very lightly. It will take time to get some effect, but you got to be very slow with it. And then we are using some kind of maroon to it. No, not maroon, some kind of brown to it, to blend the color in it. So basically it's more about how you blend the color. And be really slow. Don't press so hard the paper. Now use orange to blend these two colors. And likewise, you will do the rest of the orange, blending these two colors. I'm not showing the entire thing because it will make the video very long. So you got the point. First, you have to start with orange, and then you have to use your darker shade of red, because red is the next color to the orange. So use red, and then you have to use some brown to it to give the second tone, second and the third tone. So do the rest likewise. So for the sleeve, all the maroon portion, we are using this brownish maroon color. First we will do a layer over it just to make it a little maroon, and then we are going to use brown, combination of brown and red, to get the second and the third layer. So we'll start using this maroon color first on the first layer. Just move your pencil lightly like we did for the orange. So there you go, the layer is done. Now we need to add a darker tone to it. So we will use some red and brown to get it dark. So just run some red over it. And then some brown. Remember, be very gentle with the pencil color. The point is, the thing is, need to have patience while doing it. Don't scrub your paper with the pencil color. Be very gentle. And the inner portion is going to be the darker than the outer portion. So I'm just kind of using more of brown there. So you can see there is a darker tone of maroon in this area of the blouse, and wherever the maroon is, you have to use the same trick for the maroon. So you remember the colors which I am using to give the tone, you have to do it in the similar manner. So the main feature of Kalamkari design is that it is having a black outline. So the entire design we are first going to outline with black. So the pencil will take a while if you use it. I am going to use a pen to outline it, and this is a Macron pen. The brand name is Macron. So this is a 50 rupees pen. 0.30 mm. So you can buy the same pen and outline because it's much faster and efficient than pencil color. Pencil color will take a while if you use it for outlining. Again, don't use the pen very don't press it against paper. The whole idea is that you have to do everything very gently and lightly.
Maybe one.
So we are going to learn how to do the folds. For the folds, start with the blue color. So whatever blue you have used for your fabric, the base color, go for a deeper blue than that, and then add some of brown to it to make it look darker. I would not recommend black because black will be too dark, and it will be very difficult to blend black to it. For the maroon you have to use dark brown, and for the orange also we are going to use a combination of red, maroon and brown. Just see how I'm doing it to get an idea. So really don't pass through the white lines. Wherever it is a white, the design you see, you can use blue to that as well, but I would suggest go for gray color for it, like a darker gray for it, because it's a white area, and if you cross by blue that would look a little fake. So just go with gray there wherever there's a white. So don't define the line using blue there. Use gray color for it. If the area is bigger, let's say if the eye of the peacock is cross, if we are crossing by the eye of the peacock, use a gray color. Don't use blue color. But let's say if this is a small portion, you won't notice, but I would say better use gray there. And now you have to blend the gray with the blue. It sounds a bit complicated, but then you will get used to it once you start doing it. And then you just have to move around your pencil and just have to darken the area. The rule is same. You don't have to press your pencil so hard against the paper. Just be very gentle. So we are going to use a bit of yellow, as you already seen, I have used a silver pen for the zari design, but this is more of a yellowish zari in color, not proper golden, but kind of golden. So we will mix some watercolor and just move the brush around the design with watercolor to give that effect. Just to mute it a little. So next I'm going to do the zari in the hand. The same zari is running around the border of the skirt part as well. So this is the color. It's more like a copperish color. You'll find in fabric paint this color. So it is of 25 rupees. You can buy this color to use it. So just the design I'm outlining with this color. So you see everything is ready. Now we are going for the dupatta. And the dupatta is a see-through white net dupatta. So we are using not exact white but a bit of off-white color to just do the dupatta. And you must understand the difference between a fall of a chiffon dupatta and a net dupatta is that when you see a net dupatta, the fall is more of geometric, not that like crisp like a chiffon dupatta. Like it will not have a lot of crisp edges. It will be, have a little slight geometric edges. So yeah, so we'll just use this color, and on top of that I'll use a bit of gray to give it a double shade. On top of all this color is very difficult to notice white on this, but I'll try my best to make it work. And because of all these colors, the paper also got very thin. So yeah, you have to be very careful while doing it. So we are done with the dress, and I'm not putting the entire video of rendering because it will be too much, and nobody will have the patience to watch it all together. What I'm going to do, I'm just putting the part of the instruction. So I request you everybody to watch this video, and then after this I'll put out the speed drawing. So go through both the videos, whomsoever is interested to learn. And there is one new thing which I want to introduce is that I want you guys to kind of practice this thing, and send me the same design, your version, what you have done. Just comment in the comment box if you need, if you want to do the drawing or want me to review the drawing. You can comment in the comment box and I'll see your work and give my opinion about it. I hope it helped you in some way. If it did, make sure you like and comment. Thank you so much.